pat the divorce papers. After Erica Jayne went to court to end her marriage to Tom Girardi, Bravo fans were shocked to learn that what seemed like one of the strongest couples in Real Housewives history was not so picture-perfect after all. And what has come latest in that saga is a cryptic Girardi message shared by Erica Jayne amid divorce legal woes, which we will break down for you in today's video. How they met. The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills star announced in November 2020 that she and the powerhouse attorney had called it quits after 21 years of marriage. A source later told media, Erica and Tom had an unconventional marriage, spending a lot of time apart. Erica, who shares adult son Tommy with ex-husband Thomas Izzo, met Tom in the late 1990s while waitressing at one of his favorite West Hollywood hotspots, Chasen's. 1 year later, she decided to give him her phone number, and he subsequently reached out to her through his secretary. I told her, tell Mr. Girardi if he wants to take me out on a date. He needs to call me himself and ask me and give me enough time to prepare. The Bravo personality recalled in her 2018 memoir, Pretty Mess. You know how men are, especially if they are successful. They expect you to drop everything right away. That's not how I work. I don't care who you are. 6 months into the relationship, Erica and the lawyer got engaged. They married in January 1999. For the first 10 years of our marriage, I was by Tom's side, the expensive singer said in a February 2017 episode of Rob. I was even the first lady of a couple legal organizations. Imagine that. Due to Tom's high power job, he has only made a few appearances on the reality series since Erica joined the cast in 2015. It is likely that their divorce will play out during season 11, which began filming in early October 2020. People are always like, oh, you guys don't see each other a lot. But when we do see each other, it's 100% full-on attention, the former Chicago star said in the February 2017 episode. This is what people don't understand. It's not a detriment to the relationship. It's actually helpful. It's better than someone being in your face all the time and you're not even present. Who ended things and why? The Atlanta native confirmed in a statement to us in November 2020 that she decided to end her marriage to Tom after much consideration. She added, "This is not a step taken lightly or easily. I have great love and respect for Tom and for our years and the lives we built together. It is my absolute wish to proceed through this process with respect and with the privacy that both Tom and I deserve. I request others give us that privacy as well." A source close to the couple confessed to media in November 2020 that it was not uncommon for the now estranged couple to go several months without seeing each other. They would travel separately. Tom gave Erica a very lavish lifestyle, and she enjoyed it, the insider said. Erica has gained independence and confidence from being on Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. The exposure it has given for her singing career has given Erica a much larger fan base. In December, news came out that Erica believes Tom cheated on her during their 21-year marriage. Erica is really going through it. She's very strong, but this has been very hard for her emotionally, an insider proclaimed. A second source claimed that rumors that Erica and Tom had an agreement in terms of being with other people weren't true. Tom has yet to comment on the infidelity accusations. She went even more into detail about the separation during the June 23 episode, telling the cast, "I let go of my Lamborghini. I let go of my 16,000-square-foot home. I let go of my marriage. I let go of everything. I literally made a decision that I had to." She also told the cameras that she left because he pushed me further and further out, and she knew the marriage was headed down a really crappy path. Erica told the women during the June 23 episode that she didn't leave a note and just disappeared, leaving him to get served. "I drove him to work. I told him I loved him, and he said, 'Thanks, hun.' Like I was an employee," she explained to the last time she'd seen Tom. "I went home and started putting everything in the moving van. I drove off, went to my new place, spent the night there, and he was served the next morning." Legal trouble in paradise. Erica and Tom were hit with a lawsuit in December 2020 that accused them of embezzling settlement funds intended to help the families of Lion Air Flight 610 victims. In federal court documents obtained by media, the class action firm Edelson PC claimed that the estranged couple's divorce is a sham attempt to fraudulently protect Tom and Erica's money, and that they are on the verge of financial collapse and locked in a downward spiral of mounting debts and dwindling funds. Erica and Tom did not immediately comment on the allegations. Erica was allegedly called to testify in the fraud case in May 2020 and September 2020, before she filed for divorce that November. She was out of town on both occasions, and her hearing was rescheduled for January 2021. But even then, she's yet to testify. In December 2020, a judge in Chicago seized Tom's assets after allegations that the estranged couple withheld $2 million in client funds following the 2018 Lion Air Flight 610 crash. Tom did not attend the contempt hearing at the time, but instead called into the proceedings. The complex divorce legalities. Erica told Andy Cohen in June 2017 that she and Tom never signed a prenuptial agreement. "I'm married to a very powerful lawyer. A prenup wouldn't stand in his way anyway," she said at the time. "So, it doesn't matter whether you had one or you didn't. It's gonna be all Tom's way, I assure you." Further, Erica requested spousal support from Tom in November 2020, according to court documents obtained by us, in which she cited irreconcilable differences as the reason for their split. She also asked Tom to pay her attorney's fees and demanded that the court block her estranged husband from seeking spousal support from her. However, in November 25, 2020, court documents obtained by media showed that Tom requested to terminate the court's ability to award spousal support to Erica. He also asked her to pay his legal fees. Tom went on to tell the court in September 2020 that he has maybe a couple thousand dollars in a personal bank account, adding that his stock portfolio of millions was all gone. He said, "At one point, I had about $80 million or $50 million in cash. That's all gone. I don't have any money." He even added that he hasn't taken a penny in salary out of the firm for more than 2 years. Erica in alleged disbelief. Erica is allegedly still in disbelief about the alleged cheating and legal drama. The legal issues are unfolding one after another, and she's learning as everyone's filing. As the whole world is finding out about it, she's finding out about it. She's reading about it in the press before she even sees it, from her lawyers onto the other legal suits and drama. While she has seemingly maintained her innocence in all raw footage, Jay Edelson, the lawyer who filed the class action lawsuit against the pair, claimed she was aware of the scheme. Instagram drama. This is Justice Trisha A. Bigelow. "She was freaking my husband Tom Girardi, and he was paying her sax bill and paying for her plastic surgery," Erica captioned an Instagram post on December 18, sharing screenshots of texts. However, the judge's lawyer released a statement to the media saying Erica's actions in maliciously doxing the justice were nothing short of criminal. The attorney added, "We are considering our options to protect Justice Bigelow from further harassment." Erica's cryptic Girardi message. Erica Jane shares a message to social media amid legal woes and divorce, says Fox. Erica Jane shares cryptic Girardi message amid divorce, legal woes, says Page 6. R-H-O-B-H, Erica Jane shares cryptic Girardi message amid divorce battle with Tom Girardi, says Us Weekly. Gosh, what is this cryptic message? What deliciously enigmatic morsel could be hidden among the zero and ones of the computer? We took to social media to find out. Ah, there it is. But what could it mean? Gee, rard, duh. If only she had not been so cryptic. Perhaps it is an acrostic. Glam Squad. I really am really deceased indeed. Oh my God. Is it a message from Erica Jaina to her Glam Squad, informing them that she has in fact always been a ghost? That they have been traveling around the world with a spirit? That the Erica they think they knew is but a figment from the past? Until Erica tells us more, I suppose that is our best guess. But our curiosity is certainly piqued. With that, we come to the end of today's video. Keep following our videos to find out what spicy turn this messy Erica Tom divorce saga takes next.